What if you could find a secure, well-paying government job? But instead of a cubicle, your office has an endless horizon.
It's definitely not your 9-to-5 job.
Never a dull moment.
It's kind of fun.
Instead of a commute, you get to travel around the world.
We go places not many people get to go.
We got some time in at St. Kitts and in the Virgin Islands.
We're going to take off to French Polynesia and Nuka Hiva.
Places I've never been.
Places that are so pristine that no one in the commercial industry will ever get to.
And what if, instead of a monotonous day-in, day-out shift, your job was surrounded by cutting-edge technology and groundbreaking discoveries every day?
You get involved in projects that you read about in the news.
There's always new things that you're discovering.
You're surrounded by the latest and greatest technology, new designs, new engineering systems.
That's what you'll find in a career with the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, or NOAA, the premier science agency of the United States federal government. Aboard NOAA's growing fleet of oceanographic and fishing vessels, career positions are available at all levels of experience, including no experience. As a civilian mariner with NOAA, you'll have opportunities to train and work at sea aboard state-of-the-art scientific ships, which are commanded and managed by officers in the NOAA Corps, as well as civilian officers. The NOAA Corps is a branch of the uniformed service dedicated specifically to NOAA and under NOAA's own leadership. You'll work in concert with these officers and visiting science teams in support of NOAA's mission to further the nation's understanding of oceans and atmosphere, support commerce, and protect lives and property.
It's no small thing that we're going out and that the data we collect is the data that they use to manage the fisheries. We're part of that, there's no doubt. That's what we do.
A lot of the science that is done out here is pretty high profile stuff, and these ships support that science.
All through college you learn about NOAA as being a leader in oceanographic research, and to be able to work for the organization is pretty amazing.
The instruments that protect our coasts from deadly tsunamis are deployed by NOAA wage mariners. When disasters occur at sea, NOAA ships respond, lending their unique capabilities to mitigation efforts. And research that shapes national policy on air quality, climate change, fishery management, and many other key issues could not be maintained without competent mariners keeping the ship and its crew going.
Without the mariners, you will not accomplish any mission. A deck officer, as myself, drives the ship, whereas the mariner will be the one that's actually making sure that we get our mission completed. We will get out there, they will service the buoy, they will make sure that we get the fishing lines in and out. They're the ones that feed us. They're the ones that collect some of the scientific data, and they're the ones that clean the ship and maintain the ship and make sure it's running in proper condition.
Most of the vessels in the NOAA fleet remain in U.S. waters. Home ports are many, from Woods Hole to Kodiak, and from Charleston to Honolulu. Many of the ships in the fleet are new, with more on the way, which means you'll have the opportunity to work on high-tech, modernized platforms, such as acoustically quiet fishery science vessels, and a recently refitted ship devoted entirely to ocean exploration.
When you're bringing stuff up from the ocean, it's really exciting to see these things, especially stuff you've never seen before. Stuff that looks just like that, I don't know, weird cartoons and the science fiction stuff, you know?
It's an unbelievable science platform. Everything from acoustics, to fish surveys, to charting the ocean bottom, to studying the water column. Basically, in a nutshell, it's like the space shuttle, but on the ocean, you know?
NOAA wage mariner pay is based on an annual salary. Work schedules vary from ship to ship, but the typical work week is 7 days, and overtime is earned for all work over 8 hours, weekends, and holidays.
You're getting paid a really good salary, and they're giving you room and board, so it's all gravy, you know, especially if you're a college kid coming in and looking to do this work. You're basically just putting money in the bank.
I would say it's a very good starting salary, and the good thing about NOAA is you have a chance to move up to different ships and different qualifications, and each time you move up, your pay advances.
Full-time wage mariners are federal government employees with unmatched job security and benefits.
You know you're going to have a steady job and a steady paycheck with NOAA, whereas with the commercial sector, there's no real job security unless you have a permanent employment with a company, and then, of course, they can lay you off at any point in time.
You have the security of the government job, the federal job, and you get a government retirement, savings plan, health benefits. It's a well-rounded package.
In contrast to commercial or military schedules, NOAA ship schedules allow mariners to sail for shorter periods of time between breaks.
This particular ship we're in every couple of weeks, so you're not gone for 4 to 6 months at a whack. You do get a chance to see your family on basically a 10 to 14 day rotation, depending on the ship's mission.
You spend more time in port, there's more chances to visit your relatives, your families, connect with the life ashore. Commercial world, it's sail, 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 sail. And then you get a block of time off, and then you're not sure if you're going to go back to a ship or when you might go back. With NOAA, you have periods, you know you're going to be in port, you know you're going to have vacations planned, and you're infrequently enough so that you can actually have a regular life.
The hallmark of a NOAA wage mariner career is flexibility. NOAA's missions are diverse, and they occur all over the world. In many mariner positions, you stay on one ship doing one job. As a NOAA wage mariner, that doesn't have to be the case. NOAA mariners are given the flexibility to transfer from ship to ship, allowing them to branch out, learn new fields, advance, and pursue new licenses.
When I was 17, I went in the Navy and I was a boatswain mate as well as a collateral duty a search and rescue swimmer. And the jobs that I actually had to participate in were very specific. Working with NOAA, I've been getting a broad array of different jobs and tasks that have to be done out here, so I've gotten a lot more training in different fields. So whether it be with the diamedical technician stuff or emergency medical technician schools or coxswain schools, davit and crane schools, firefighting schools, there's a lot more on your plate because you're working with a smaller group of people.
Another level of flexibility is offered with NOAA's augmentation pool, where mariners can fill in for each other for short periods, offering flexibility when you need to take leave and the chance to try out new jobs in new places.
You come out here for one cruise and then you go to another vessel, so you can experience the wonder of it all. You know, you can go out there and do fisheries 1 month and come over here and do buoys with us, and next minute go on the Ron Brown and go return to the Titanic for all you know.
I've done everything from retrieving moorings and buoys in the Bering Sea, to mammal observation in Southeast Alaska, to fishing for lobsters in the Northwest Hawaiian Islands.
I don't know what kind of other flexibility you have out in the commercial fleet. A lot of it's union. You kind of get contracted to one boat. You do what you can. Out here, I know if you get tired on this boat and you want to try something else, the way is open if you're a good worker.
Plus, they provide all the training that you need for your job and more.
They're going to teach you everything, and you don't have to have really any prior skills coming in other than common sense.
The same training that a wage mariner could get through NOAA is something that they would have to pay for in the outside world themselves to get a license.
The way that people gain promotions and go up in levels of responsibility, either in the deck or the engine room, is through different licenses.
Some of the training for the deck department would be obtaining your AB Unlimited documentation, or even if you sailed as a junior engineer or an oiler on this vessel, you can eventually work your way up to a licensed engineer position, all provided by NOAA.
If you're willing to do the work and put in the time, NOAA's willing to back you and give you the training and let you go all the way up.
Most NOAA mariner positions fall under one of four departments: the deck department, the engineering department, the steward department, and the survey department. NOAA is a multifaceted organization, and shipboard missions are very diverse. But crucial to the success of each one is the role played by the ship's deck department. A NOAA ship doesn't depart or tie up at a dock or arrive on a location without the deckhands handling lines and weighing anchor. From fishing trawl nets to oceanographic instruments, to rescue boats to supplies, the deck department is directly involved with everything that goes on or off a NOAA ship.
Each person that's in a part of this crew has a lot of responsibilities, whether it be being a coxswain running the boats out there and keeping the scientists safe while you're out there performing their jobs, or you're on deck running the cranes, handling lines. There's a lot that goes on that you have to be ready for. It's extremely important to have trust in your shipmates when you're doing this, and you need to be confident upon what your tasks are and what you're doing. We have training all the time as well. When we have our drills, it's to keep our skills proficient.
The engineering department is in charge of everything involved with the propulsion of the ship and the safe and efficient operation of all the ship's systems.
We have a crew of 6 engineers, and our duties are to keep everything on the ship running, whether it be hotel services all the way down to the main propulsion to the mission support equipment.
Just keeping a NOAA ship running is a full-time operation, but that doesn't mean it's a monotonous job that only happens in the belly of the ship. With the variety of operations in the NOAA fleet, there are new challenges with each mission all around the ship.
Because of the duties of the engine room, we are quite involved with everything on the ship, and a lot of that overlaps with the mission work, you know, whether it be with the support equipment, the winches, the hydraulics, the conveyor system in the wet lab. We do get involved with everything on the ship.
Since NOAA is at the forefront of oceanic research, its newer ships are state-of-the-art. A career in NOAA's engineering department offers the chance of being on the cutting edge of new design and new engineering. If the engineering department is in charge of keeping the ship moving, the stewards are in charge of keeping the crew moving.
Would you like some?
All over the fleet, NOAA mariners are saying the same thing about the food served on NOAA ships.
The food on this ship is awesome.
I think the food's awesome.
The food's awesome.
The steward we have right now, I wouldn't trade it for the world.
It's good, man. It's wholesome, and they just keep it coming. It's like full plate every meal.
The food is outstanding, and it really, really is a strong point in the morale on board a ship.
For dinner tonight, we have veal chops and vegetable sauce, and we also have a mustard rub pork loin, which we have going on in the oven right now. We give them all fresh ingredients. We do fresh soups on a daily basis, fresh vegetables, and we also give them a huge variety of choices. We don't limit our menu to just one or two different items.
I mean, you just see it, you know, we have Mongolian night. We got prime rib once a week. I mean,
some fresh cod, some fresh haddock.
Never-ending free buffet.
I look down and I'll say, you know, if I was in Newport, it'd be like a $60 meal.
It's a good meal for the crew every day. It energizes them and motivates them. It also gives them something really to look forward to, you know, because we really put an extra effort into what we put together.
If there's one thing that's produced on every NOAA cruise, it's data. From surveys of fish stocks, to remote sensing, to the locating of shipwrecks, massive amounts of data are mined on every trip made by every ship. This information is the main objective of most missions, and the proper management of the data is the crucial function of NOAA's survey department.
You can think of it as an onboard scientist. I'm responsible for all the data acquisition on a vessel.
NOAA ships host all manner of science teams, each requiring various types of equipment and data collection methods. NOAA survey technicians serve as the link between the scientists and the crew, providing technical assistance, maintaining scientific instruments, and safeguarding the data they collect.
I do my daily maintenance of the sensors and monitoring the data quality. As a survey tech, you kind of have to be a jack of all trades because you have to fix instruments on the deck and know how to do fish sampling.
Most survey techs come in at a baseline having at least 2 years of experience or at least an undergrad degree in some form of science. We do have hydrographic vessels in the NOAA fleet where they are doing charting, and you're able to start in there as an assistant survey tech. With some simple training, you'll be a member of a large department, so it's much more on-the-job training.
Basically to identify shoals, obstructions, wrecks, anything like that on the bottom, areas that are mischarted, and the whole purpose behind it is safe navigation of your commercial mariners. There's a whole commercial industry that's out sailing. If our charts aren't correct, if they're not updated, the most accurate information that that we can get there, it's a tragedy. If a ship goes aground, you're looking at not only your mariner's life, but the effect that it would have on the fish and the marine life from the pollution that it would cause too.
It's perfect job for working on the water, getting to see different places,
if you like equipment, things like that, this is what you want to do.
Aboard NOAA's fleet of ships, officers and scientists will come and go. But critical to the success of every operation are the ship's full-time personnel, the single greatest resource in the NOAA fleet, the wage mariner.
Nobody does what NOAA does.
Every trip I come back learning something new.
It's a great opportunity and a great experience, and I do it again in a heartbeat.
If you have any interest in going to sea, this is working for NOAA would be an ideal opportunity.
I'm positive that this experience will open a lot of doors for me.
If we're going to continue to research our planet and learn more about global climate change and all these different things that are going on, we're going to need some really good sailors to go out there and retrieve that data. So I see a bright future in the mariner community here in NOAA.
Knowing that I'm contributing to the larger body of scientific work that's out there, I find that incredibly gratifying.
Being on a NOAA ship, it's the intangibles that matter more than anything else. It's not the paycheck, it's not the steady employment, it really is the science. You get to be on board with crews from National Geographic, some of the preeminent scientists in the world doing cutting-edge studies. Where else are you going to find that? You won't. You have a chance to be part of something bigger than just a commercial organization. And that's what NOAA is about.